Yay! Christmas has begun. Feels like it has. I'm so grateful for everyone being here tonight. My name is Graham Baird. I'm lead pastor of this incredible church, and we welcome everyone here tonight. Ni hao to all of our friends from the Herald Corral. And we just wanted to say this is going to be an amazing evening. We welcome all those who are watching on video tonight, and perhaps wherever you are watching this, you may just feel the power of Christ in your life as you listen to the music. We want to say a couple of things. If you're new to our church, there are bathrooms just around the side and over here, and so just feel free to use those at any point. Also, there are medical services, in case those should be needed, and just put your hand up. You put your hand up. Okay, it's okay. Okay, just checking. But the ushers will help you with that. We are taking an offering tonight, but 50% of the entire offering is going to Butte fires, to the campfires. Half of tonight's offering is going up there. So, and the other half is going to just basically pay for tonight. So no profit will be made, so you can be assured that every penny will be put to good use. There is a reception just after this wonderful concert tonight, and it's just around the corner and to the side, and that's in the fellowship hall. If you would choose to join us for any other events here at Burl Press, we would love to have you on Christmas Eve. We have like six services or something like that. I've lost count, really. But everyone who comes on Christmas Eve gets a little book that I wrote and a CD, more importantly, that Alex put together, Alex Bootson, who is the director. It is Yuletide Jazz. Everyone gets a free CD on Christmas Eve and a free book. I think that's about it. Who wants to hear some music? No, that's not going to be good enough. All right, let's pack up. Let's go home. Who wants to hear music? All right, let's hear it.
Thank you. Throughout history, God has called all people into a relationship with the divine creator. The faithful have responded. The narratives of prophecy and proclamation appear throughout the Bible as humankind learns to be in relationship with God. This story we love to tell is foreshadowed in
the Word of God from the book of Isaiah. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given. The government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
In order to bring people together for the worship of Christ, the newborn Son of God, several means have been employed: light, angels, shepherds, word of mouth, visits by kings, drums and pipes. None have proclaimed good news and celebration to the people more than bells. Let's listen.
Thank you.
almost all of us, the wonder of Christmas can be seen in children's eyes and experienced in their squeals of delight. What is even more profound is a child's connection with a baby. Christmas scenes of Jesus in the manger, trees with snow falling, and children looking at the ornaments that signify family and family history. Traditions and new family beginnings are heightened by the presence of a newborn. Let's listen to the invitation and become childlike for a moment. Biblical narratives of Jesus' birth recorded in the Gospels of Matthew and Luke are magic to the ear and provide warmth to the heart. Matthew's narrative highlights the wise men from the East. Luke's narrative highlights the wonder of the announcements to Mary, Joseph, and the shepherds. Hear the word of God as recorded in Luke 2.
The birth of Jesus. At that time, the Roman Emperor Augustus decreed that a census should be taken throughout the Roman Empire. This was the first census taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All returned to their own ancestral towns to register for this census. Because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he had to go to Bethlehem in Judea, David's ancient home. He traveled there from the village of Nazareth in Galilee. He took with him Mary, to whom he was engaged, who was now expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. You will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth, lying in a manger." Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph. And there was the baby lying in the manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them.
Thank you.
From the time of the birth of Jesus through today and on beyond our ability to know, songs of devotion have risen and will rise to commemorate and hold up this sacred story. The following carols have been sung by millions.
Thank you.
Stories abound of the miracles of Jesus recorded in the Gospels. The blind who see, the deaf who hear, the lame who leap. We too can do miraculous things by helping those in need. Today we are taking a free will retiring offering to help those who have lost so much in the campfire this last November. There will be boxes for your offerings at the rear of the sanctuary. Please be generous. Our giving hearts start with one small child who became the savior of us all.
Thank you.
It is always fitting to realize that God's faithful people are recipients of amazing grace. As the great hymn states, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we'd first begun. There are not enough times to sing the carols of Christmas that we love. There are not enough days to celebrate the life in Christ that we have. Join us as we sing more beloved carols.
Thank you.
In our last section, we'd like you to know what our arranger, Bob Krogstad, had to say.
Repeat the Sounding Joy is actually our emotional and musical finale. We wanted to pair two famous Handelian tunes in such a way that the choir could enjoy the immense delight of singing one of G.F. Handel's greatest, "For Unto Us a Child is Born," and then inspire the congregation to join them in a rousing arrangement of "Joy to the World."
Think about this then. "For Unto Us a Child is Born" was written 277 years ago, and the tune to "Joy to the World" 274 years ago. The text for "Joy to the World" was written 299 years ago by Isaac Watts. This demonstrates for many of us the timeless and eternal joy we have in this season.
Thank you.
Let's keep it going. Let's keep it going for Joshua Law and the Herald Chorale. Let's keep it going for the orchestra. The Chancel Choir of Burl Press. The Children's Choir of Burl Press. The Handel Choir of Burl Press. Emily Bender and the beautiful solo. Igor. Here he is. Yin Yan, Salim Song, Jeffrey Chow, Vicky Chow, Susan Simpson on the narration, and Ed Willig. Thank you so much. And where would we be at without the indefatigable Court Bender? What if you were to find out that tonight a child was to come into your life who would be the king of the universe? For to us a child is born. Go in the name of the one for those for whom the child has been born. And one more thing. Please stay around for a reception afterwards and thank all these incredible musicians and put something in the offering plate. It's going right up to Butte County in the next week. God bless you. We'll see you again. Take care.